Good morning, everyone. Let us start this session. So this is lecture number 10. In the previous session, we have seen the how to use the scientific calculator. So today we will start with the module number 1. And in that we will start the section 1.2, which is the resultant calculation. So in the section 1.2, which is the resultant calculation, the first is resultant of coplanar and non-coplanar force system. So out of this, we will start with the coplanar force system. So we have seen the classification for the force system, that is a coplanar and non-coplanar. So in the coplanar force system, we will see one by one the resultant for concurrent forces, then resultant for the parallel forces, and resultant for non-concurrent, non-parallel general force system. Okay. So under coplanar and non-coplanar, we have again classification as a concurrent, parallel, non-concurrent, non-parallel, that is a general force system. Okay. And after that, we will study the moment. Okay. The first is moment due to force, and second is the moment due to couple. Okay. So the system of forces, the meaning of system of forces is, if you have a object and if the forces are acting on the object like this, okay. So two or more forces are acting on any object, then we can say the given system is a system of forces. Okay. So the system of forces is classified as coplanar and non-coplanar. Okay. Coplanar means forces acting in a single plane. So if you consider one rectangular plane, and if the forces are acting like this, only in this plane, let us take this F1, F2, F3, all these are vectors, okay? Then we can say this is a coplanar force system. The meaning of non-coplanar is, for that, consider one cube. Okay. So if the forces are acting on the faces of the cube like this, so all these forces, they are acting in the different plane. Okay. So this one face we can consider as a plane. So this is the second plane. This is third plane. Okay. So this is called as a non-coplanar force system. It is also called as a space force. Okay. The meaning of space force is space force in a three dimension. Now this coplanar and non-coplanar forces, they are again classified as concurrent, parallel, and general. Okay. Concurrent means if all the forces, they are passing through a single point, it is called as a concurrent force system. So if you take the point O, and this is first force F1, this is F2, this is F3, okay? So all these forces, they are passing through a single point. This is called as a concurrent forces. Parallel means if you have the rod AB, okay, on this rod, we have force F1, F2, F3, F4, okay. So the line of action of these forces, F1 to F4, these line of actions, they are parallel to each other, okay. So this is called as a parallel force system. So in the parallel force system, we have like parallel forces. So we have two forces, F1 and F2. Okay. These two forces are parallel to each other and their direction is same. This is called as a like parallel forces. Second is unlike parallel forces. If the forces or line of action of the forces parallel to each other, but direction is opposite. Okay. So here F2, F1. So this is called as a unlike parallel forces. And next is general force system. So meaning of general force system is forces will not pass through a single point as that of the concurrent force system, and even the line of action will not be parallel. So this is called as a non-concurrent, non-parallel general force system. So again, consider the example for the rod. We have one wooden piece or wooden rod, AB. It is subjected to various forces. Okay, so first is F1. This is F2. F3. F4, like this. So if you observe this system, that is a system of forces, then forces are not passing through a single point. Okay, even the line of action is not parallel to each other. So this is called as non-concurrent and non-parallel. Okay, or it is also called as a general force system. So this is the classification for coplanar force system. Similarly, we have the same classification for non-coplanar or general force system. Next part, which was the prerequisite for the first module, it was the principle of transmissibility. So we have already discussed this in the provisional classes. So meaning of principle of transmissibility is, if you apply a force on a rigid object, so this is one rigid object. So I'm applying force F at point A, okay? So because of the force, object will receive some acceleration and it will start moving. So instead of point A, I can shift the force at other point along the line of action. So line of action means the imaginary line. So this is called as a line of action. So I can shift the force from point A to other point B on the same line of action. The effect will not change. Okay. So this is called as a principle of transmissibility. Okay. So if you apply the force at this point B, still object will have the same acceleration. That means we can show the force anywhere on the line of action. So simple example, if you have one rigid object and initially we're applying the force F at point A, and if you draw the line of action, then we can show the force from point A to other point B. Same force. So effect will remain same. This is called as the principle of transmissibility. After that, resolution of forces. So resolution of forces means breaking the single force into two components or two parts such that if components are combined together would have the same effect. Okay. So in a simple language, resolution means we divide the force into two parts. So one part will act along x-axis and other part will act along y-axis. So here one force is shown. Let's take this force as a F. And this angle with respect to x-axis. So consider this is the x-axis. And this is y-axis. So this is called as a resolution. Okay. So some part of the force F, it will act along x-axis. So this is called as an x component. Okay. And some part of this force F will act along y-axis. This is called as a F1. So if you combine these two forces, you will get the resultant value as a F. Okay. So this force, which is the original force, this is called as a net force. Or this is called as a resultant. Okay. So we have seen how to write the equation for Fx and Fy. Okay. So always remember. So to find out the equation for Fx, observe the angle of the force. Okay, so this theta angle is adjacent to Fx. Okay, so Fx is adjacent. So Fx value will be F cos theta. Okay, and Fy, it is opposite to this angle theta. So this is Fy is equal to F sine theta. Why it is opposite? Because from this point, if you draw the perpendicular, okay, so this component, it is equal to this component, okay, or this side. So this is opposite side. That's why you can write Fy is equal to F sine theta, Fx is equal to F cos theta. So this is the resolution. Now, next part is composition, that means calculation of resultant force. So this is the section 1.2. So we will calculate the resultant force for concurrent force system. Then for the parallel force system, and third will be non-concurrent, non-parallel. Okay, so all these force systems, they are the part of coplanar force system. Okay, first we will only discuss the coplanar force system. And after that, we will calculate the resultant for non-coplanar force system. So what is meaning of resultant? When a body is subjected to two or more forces, their effect can be replaced by the action of a single force. That single force is called as a resultant. Okay. So in a simple language, we can say the resultant force is the net force acting on the body. So here you can see two examples. There is one block having the mass M. Okay. Suppose it is resting on the ground. And it is subjected to two forces. Okay. With the equal magnitude, 50 newtons. So they're acting in the opposite direction. So what is the net effect in the first example? Net effect will be zero. Okay, so there is no resultant on this system. But if you observe the second example, so second object is also subjected to two forces. One is 50 Newton along positive X direction and 80 Newton along negative X direction. Okay. Their net effect will be 30 Newton. Okay. And its direction is towards the negative x-axis. So we can write the resultant value, which is equal to. So when we add the forces, we should consider their sign. So 50 is positive x direction. So this is plus 50. 80, it is acting along negative x direction. So this is minus 80. So resultant is minus 30 Newton. Okay. And as the force is a vector quantity, so we should give the proper direction. So this value, that is the magnitude, we can write as R is equal to 30 Newton. Okay. Just I am removing the negative sign. And you can show the direction by this arrow. Okay. So this arrow direction, it means that the magnitude is minus 30 Newton. Okay. So this is the representation for the result. Suppose this is 50 Newton and this is 30 Newton. Okay. So in this case, your resultant will be towards the positive X direction. So R is equal to plus 50 minus 30. So this is equal to 20 Newton. Okay. And here you can give the sign direction as a 20 Newton. It means that it is towards the positive X direction. Okay. So if the force is positive, don't change the sign. Just give the direction. Okay. But if the force is negative, then for the direction, should make this positive 30 Newton and then give the direction towards negative X. Okay, so this is the meaning of resultant. Resultant is nothing but the net effect or net force on the body. Now to calculate the resultant for the concurrent force system only, there is one law, which is a law of parallelogram. So we have already discussed this. What is a law of parallelogram? So law of parallelogram is applicable if there are two forces acting at a point, then we can find out the resultant by constructing the parallelogram like this. So here we have two forces. One is a P and second is a Q. So two forces, they are acting at a point O. So to find out the resultant or the net effect of force P and Q, just construct the parallelogram like this. So draw this line parallel to vector P and draw this line parallel to vector Q. Okay. So this diagonal, it will give the resultant in magnitude and direction. Okay. So this is the resultant R. Now its equation is to find out the magnitude. You can use this relation. So we have already seen the derivation. How do we get this R and theta? So you can go through that lecture. So resultant is equal to square root P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos of alpha, where alpha is angle between these two forces, P and Q. Okay. So this is the magnitude. Magnitude means value of the resultant. And the direction of the resultant, we can calculate by this angle theta. Okay. So with respect to force P. So this theta means resultant direction, which is equal to tan inverse Q sine alpha upon P plus Q cos of alpha. Okay. So this theta angle, it is with respect to P force. Suppose if you are interested in calculating the theta angle with respect to Q force, then just change the equation. So theta is equal to tan inverse. So just replace Q by P. So this is P sine alpha upon Q plus P cos alpha. Okay. So this theta angle, it is with respect to force Q. And this theta angle, it is with respect to force P. So by using this law of parallelogram, we can find out the resultant. Only condition is there must be two forces at a single point. Okay. But if there are more than two forces, then how to find out the resultant? So resultant of the concurrent force system. And if there are more than two forces, okay. So I will consider one general case. Okay, so this is the rectangular coordinate system and this is the origin O. Okay, so at the origin we have four forces. Let us take this F1 and its angle, this is theta 1. Okay, next we have F2, its angle with respect to negative x-axis as a theta 2, then F3, this is theta 3, and F4. Okay, and our aim is to find out what is the net effect. So for that, if there are more than two forces, then we cannot use law of parallelogram directly, okay? Because law of parallelogram we can only use if there are two forces at a single point. So for such type of problems, we will use the resolution of forces. Okay, so your first step is for such type of problems, resolve all the forces along x and y direction. That means find out their components. So just I will separate this. So consider only force F1. And force F1, it is in the first quadrant. Okay. And its angle, this is theta 1 with respect to positive x-axis. So resolution means we have to find out their component along x and y direction. So this is the x component and this is the y component. Okay. So this is fx. This is fy. So here fx, this component is adjacent to angle theta 1. So equation will be f1, which is the net force, into cos theta 1. And Fy component, this is opposite to angle theta 1. So Fy is equal to F1, which is the net force, sine theta 1. Okay. So these are the two components of the force F1. Similarly for force F2. This angle is theta 2. Now show the component. So when you show the component, always observe the direction for the net force. So F2 is acting in this direction. So this is your X component. And this is the Y component. Okay. Now here Fx, this is equal to, as a theta 2, it is adjacent to Fx. So Fx is equal to net force is F2 cos theta 2 and Fy is equal to F2 sine theta 2. Because y component, it is opposite to angle theta 2. Okay. Now, only difference is this x component, if you observe the direction, it is towards the negative x axis. Okay. So, show this direction as a negative sign. So, minus f2 cos theta 2, fy is positive, along positive y direction. Now, consider the next force, which is the f3. And this angle is theta 3. So this is the x component. This is y component. So here fx, this is equal to, again fx is adjacent to theta 3. So net force is f3 cos theta 3. And this is negative because it is acting along negative x direction. And Fy, this is equal to, Fy is opposite to angle theta 3. So this is equal to, force is F3, that is a net force, into sine theta 3. And Fy is also acting towards negative y direction. So this is minus. Okay. So these two components, they are for F3. These two components for F2. And this is for F1. Okay. And the last force, which is F4. This angle is theta 4. And this is the x component. This is y component. Okay. So your fx, x component is adjacent to theta 4. So this is f4 cos theta 4. And y component, it is opposite to angle theta 4. So this is sine. So this is F4 sine theta 4. Now decide the direction. Fx is towards positive x direction. Okay. But Fy, it is towards negative x direction. So this is a minus. Okay. So this is the first step, that is called as a resolution. Okay. That means find out the x and y component for each and every force in the given problem. Okay. Now next is we have to find out the summation. That means we have to add all the x components so that we can observe or we can find out what is the net force along the x direction. After that, add all y component. That is called as a summation. Okay. So second step to calculate the resultant is we have to find out the summation, that is called as a summation fx and summation f1. So summation fx, so this is nothing but the addition of all x components, and this summation fx, it will give the net force in x direction only. Okay. And second, find out the summation fy. So this is addition of all y components. Okay. When I say addition, it means that we have to consider the proper sign. Okay. And it is a net force in the y direction. So you can refer the resolution and accordingly write the summation fx. So your summation fx will be, first is F1 cos theta 1. Then we have negative minus F2 cos theta 2. Again minus F3 cos theta 3. and plus f4 cos theta 4. Okay, so this is the summation. Then summation fy, this is equal to f1 sin theta 1 plus f2 sin theta 2 minus f3 sin theta 3 minus f4 sin theta 4. Okay, so this fx, summation fx, we can represent as a rx. Okay, because this r value is nothing but the resultant, and rx means x component of resultant. And this summation fy we can write as a ry. So here you can write, this is x component of resultant. Our final aim is we have to find out the resultant, and y, ry is nothing but y component of the resultant force. Okay, so once you get summation fx and summation fy, then depending on the sign of rx and ry, you have to decide the proper quadrant. Okay, so as this is the general case, so I will consider rx this as a positive, okay, and ry it is also positive. So if rx and ry both are positive, then you can show the rx along positive x direction, and ry is also positive, so this is the positive y direction. Okay, and after that you can show the resultant force in the first quadrant. So this is the net effect. Okay, so the resultant we can find out by constructing the right angle triangle. Okay, so this side it will be ry, and this is the rx. So use the Pythagoras, you will get r is equal to square root rx square plus ry square. Okay, and what is rx? It is nothing but summation fx. So r is equal to square root summation of fx square plus summation fy square. So this is how you can find out the resultant force. This is just a magnitude. So this is the magnitude of the resultant. Okay, now to find out the direction, we should find out the angle of resultant with one of the component or one of the axis. So rx, it acts along x axis, ry is along y axis. So consider this direction theta with respect to x axis. Okay, so how we can find out the theta? So just